I had a chronic disease for 35, 40 years. I had several of them, but the one we'll talk about is called ankylosing spondylitis. It is a very slow-growing arthritic condition in its later stages. You're all curled up in a ball looking at the floor because you're all frozen into an arthritic ball of bone. So you just, all your joints just fuse. And for the providers that I was seeing, first of all, I didn't get diagnosed. So without a diagnosis, you don't even know what you have. All you know is that you hurt horribly and you can't function. So some people think a diagnosis is going to bring the answer. Most often, that's not true. But so I did get diagnosed in Mexico after 35 years of progressively degenerative joint function and pain. And in fact, what sent me to Mexico, by the way, and what got me to look at alternative medicine, meaning people with other tools, rather than just a particular bag of tools, was the last tool I was offered was surgery for all my joints. And it just struck me that that wasn't going to work. So I said, I'm going to go look at alternative medicine, as much as I thought it was all baloney, because I fully believed in the tool bag of science, which is traditional medicine. Fully believed in that for 35 years, despite the fact that I continued on a decline for those 35 years. And I did everything they want, every test, every specialist, I did it all. And then I was offered surgery and I said, I better look outside at some other tools. So when I went to Mexico, this doctor there said I had ankylosing spondylitis. What was cool was, not only could he prove that I had the disease by looking at the x-rays, which all these other people looked at the x-rays, this guy looks at the x-rays and says, this is what you got. What was really cool was he was also able to fix it. He had a new therapy at the time, 30 years ago, called prolotherapy, which is now available in the United States, and he regenerated all of my joints. So while I was doing this alternative journey, I didn't stop at one provider. I went to many other providers, and not only did my joint pain get fixed, did my allergies get fixed, did my cancer get fixed, did my emotional surges and valleys get fixed, but through hitting these excellent people with different tools, I learned what I needed to do to communicate with the body through muscle testing and allow the body to develop its own system of healing, which is called advanced health training now. And so that's the whole story. So today I don't deal, like many of my clients, with disease. I don't manage disease. I don't watch my diet for disease. I'm not researching the latest machines in Germany for disease. I'm not reading the documents coming out on what they think they're gonna do with the new, because you know why? I'm just well. Once you get well, once your body makes you well, you have to do all that. Advanced cell training was an awakening. The first part of the awakening occurred when I hit that doctor in Mexico who fixed all my joint pain with prolotherapy. And he was very quick to point out the shortcomings in the tool bag that was being offered to me. And so the first real shift was, wait a minute, I know that I'm not a medical person, I'm not a doctor, but now I know that I can question what they're doing because it's not working. Because this man was telling me why it wasn't working while he was fixing me. So what he was doing was working, and he was poking holes in all of the theories that were in the other tool bag. That particular shift allowed me to take the power away from other people, and I became my own health advocate instead of total reliance on the experts. You need to think for yourself. And my first thought should have been, wait a minute, I've been doing the same thing here for 35 years, and I'm worse than I've ever been. And that thought didn't occur to me until another doctor started to fix me and said, hey, you know, here's why everything you've done hasn't worked. So that shift of power from, I will believe what the authorities say without question, to wait a minute, I'm not getting any better. What do I need to do to get better? That's the first shift. And then as I started to experience these new approaches that traditional science would sniff at, for example, muscle testing is something that they see as total quackery, yet because of it, I don't have cancer anymore, and I don't have allergies anymore, and my joints now regenerate, and I don't have to get booster shots from this wonderful guy in Mexico. You start to learn what really works when you free yourself from the corral that they keep you in, at least I was kept in for 35 years, that I put myself in, by the way, by believing that science and medicine had all of the answers, you can do no better. In fact, I'll tell you how bad I was. My brother was walking with a cane. Now, my brother used to run probably 10 miles a day. He was an amazing athlete. And when he turned about 40, he was unable to run, and he's walking around stooped over with a cane. So my brother goes to Mexico, and he gets those prolotherapy shots. He comes back 3 months later running. He had had no surgery. And where my mind was at the time was, what's wrong with him? Doesn't he know we have the very best medicine and science here in America? You know, and I was able to dismiss the fact that he was running again. So I'm not sure how we put blinders on ourselves. I certainly put some pretty thick blinders on me. And what happened was, when the doctor in America offered me surgery for my joints, the light bulb that went on was, wait a minute, my brother's running and he didn't have any surgery. So I don't know what it's going to take to overcome the very thorough programming that we experience here around science. You've got to look at one thing: is what you are doing working? And I'm not talking about a little help. Is it getting you to where you were before you got chronically sick? If the answer is no, you got to keep looking, even at things that traditional thought would say is quackery. That's what saved me. But I was stuck there for 35 years, so I know it's not an easy shift. So I had one doctor fixing me, healing me after 35 years when everybody else couldn't even diagnose me, saying, here's the shortcomings of this system. And then he handed me a book called Confessions of a Medical Heretic that a doctor wrote, you know, what is going on in medicine and where it is failing. And man, it called me really called me up short, and then I became my own thinking advocate. And from all of that irreverence came the advanced cell training program, and many, many people are very, very happy with it. So,
thank you for watching. If you found this video interesting, please click the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time we release a new video.